Now, I have to say that this abaya is one of the simplest to make. The only thing hard about it is the fact that it's actually just a little bit difficult to carry because it's it weighs quite a bit. And when you're sewing this, the only hardest part on this is the fact that it does tend to drag away from you. And that's something that you have to be very, very careful on. Now, I pressed this, and what I want to do, you know, I just want to seam this on top. And when you seam on top, try and keep your stitching fairly small. And sew very close to the edge. I think that will just neaten it off and give it, let it sit a little bit better. I've overlocked all the edges, and now when you come to turning the hem, which is the next thing we're going to do, turning a hem on a slightly curved edge is a little bit difficult, and my advice would be if you have an overlocker, then preferably overlock before turning over. Secondly, if you do not have an overlocker, then you do a single turn once and then do a secondary turn, and that will give you a neater finish. It can be done on the one go, but there are problems because you often what you encounter is the problem of, now I'm going to double stitch this all the way around. What you encounter is a slight bit of puckering in the fabric. I think it's such a beautiful color, is this color, especially when you know I'm going to somewhere like Hajj. I know you're not supposed to cause attention to yourself, but you know what, we're women and we love our beautiful things, and I think that's probably I think I would like to wear this because it looks elegant and it looks very sophisticated. You know, there is always a certain, you know, certain aura and pride, I suppose. And I don't know, I'm one of those people, right, that like to, I think us Muslims have got a really bad image, and what we need to do is sort of profile that image to actually more classier look. So when people look at us, they don't look down on us, they look at us with envy. I know that's not Islamic and that shouldn't be the case, but you know what, it's a harsh world, and I think we often get criticized quite badly. I think as Muslims, we need to be more proud and not arrogant proud, but proud as, you know, the righteous proud of our religion and of our wear and our ethnic being and so on. So this is turning the hem. I'm doing this on the right side and just gradually turning it over and blending it in, because otherwise you can get, you know, and this has been overlocked, so. And we want a nice, neat result on this. Now, when you come to sort of like a high point, like a turning point, then what you can do is just raise the foot of your machine like this and just ease the fabric out, and that will stop any puckering. Now, as I mentioned, try and get your fabric to sit on top of the machine, because otherwise you need a good sound surface. Because one of the difficulties of sewing these abayas is they are very, very heavy, and you need to be very, very careful on when you come to lifting these. Honestly, I have got such a load of work. And now these abayas themselves literally probably take an hour to make, which is nothing for the kind of result that I will achieve. I've developed such a bad cough lately that winter is just beginning to come in, and I'm a little bit fearful that I'm going to have a bad year this year. Last year was okay, but the year before I suffered from so many bad flus, and if you watch any of my old videos, you'll hear me talking and I'm really feeling bad. And I can actually see that happening this year, because already I am suffering from a really nasty bout of cough. It's like I've got very, very heavy chest, and I'm not feeling brilliant about it. I'm one of those people who pushes myself, you know, even when I'm not feeling absolutely 100%. I woke up this morning, and my intention was to wake up for tahajjud. I didn't get up for tahajjud, but I got up very early fajr, and because I had a lot of work to do, I sort of wanted an early start, because lately what's happened is I've sort of gone into a bit of a lazy mode in respect of starting early in the morning. I think it was okay when Halima was at school. You know, I'd get up for her and then I won't go back to bed, I'll come straight to work. And lately what's happened is that she's at college, and sometimes I wake up for fajr, well, I wake up for fajr every day, but I end up going back to sleep, which is not good. That's a sign of serious laziness, and I don't like a serious laziness in that respect. I think one of the things that I noticed about most Asian women is that they're a bit lazy in the morning, and they tend to get up very late in the morning, which is a very, very bad thing to do, because an early start gives you so much barakah that I can't explain. Okay, so that's the hem done. I've already done the other hem. Now that's the, what you can often get is, can you see that slight bit of a ripple? That will go out once it's ironed, but if you're turning it double, then that can be more. If it's a one turn, it's fine, but if it's a double turn, then you can tend to get that more. Now what we're going to do now is we're going to just stitch this prior to double stitching it. Because there's two layers, they can often become difficult to stitch on the... So what we're going to do is just close these off. So there's going to be four of these seams. Close all four seams off before doing the side seams to close the abaya off. You can lengthen your stitch here.